I've known Elke for quite a few years now, I guess. Probably 8, 9, maybe 10. And Elka's always got a beautiful smile, would you say? I think most times. And Elka's a loving, kind person. And I think she would help anybody if they're down and out. Anyways, I'm going to read a quote from Elka's website. For years, anxiety limited and dwarfed my work and relationships. For years, I did not know what it was. I felt anxiety as depression, work, panic attacks, procrastination, headaches, exhaustion, and sometimes felt physically ill. It has been a passion to find out how I could change channels in my brain to manage the harder, not so pleasant feelings like anxiety, and live to my fullest potential, to live my dreams and thrive. It was important to me to use methods that were approachable, simple, healthy, long-lasting, and successful. In my book, I share the gems that have shifted old thinking patterns of myself and that of my students and clients. I am certain we can do this. Now my honor to introduce Elke Scholz.
Happy New Year, everybody.
Thank
Happy
you.
New Year.
Happy New Year.
As well.
Retching guts, it sucks. I feel like a blender. A pincushion would be a treat. Raw, like spikes in raw meat. To end or pause or rest from thought, racing, pacing, dicing, slicing, this way, that way, anyway, as long as I'm asleep. The energy, it hurts until it stops dead. Dead. Dreams, nightmares, streams, scares, uncover, stutter, tough. Regretting every word, somehow insanely absurd. My blood, it's frothing. My sweat is fermenting. Lost, dizzy, fractured, hoping. Vacant, worry, just coping. To end or pause or rest from thought. Racing, pacing, slicing, dicing. Anyway, anyway, this way, that way. As long as I'm asleep, the pain hurts until it stops dead. Dead. A maze with no end. Reactions. No actions. Grinding my tongue, run away. Contradiction nails my lungs. Throat empty again. I can't breathe. I breathe too much. Ever tasteless thorn I clutch. Ever wishing I can't touch. To end or pause or rest from thought. Racing, pacing, dicing, slicing. This way, that way, anyway. As long as I'm asleep. The energy hurts until it stops dead. So my question is, why does the brain react this way? What causes pathological anxiety, chronic pain? What causes inhibiting depression in the brain? How do we overcome this to be more happy? For me, this presents a mystery. It's a question, and it's an opportunity. So I got to have some fun with this. We have a knowing that we can think differently, and generally we don't. We have a knowing we can change channels. Generally, we don't. Deepak Chopra and the National Science Foundation say that we have 50,000 thoughts a day. 50,000 thoughts a day. Most of them are repetitive, and
part of that reason is we would go insane if they were all different. And the other, they come from our beliefs. 50,000 thoughts. So, now this isn't going to be artistic tonight, just saying. So that's our brain. So what is the function of the brain? What's the function of the brain?
Stores memory.
It does. And it keeps us alive. So I'm going to actually put that in here because we need that. So it beats. What else? It actually, we have other organs. So what are they? Just pop them.
Your heart, your lungs, your kidneys, your pancreas. Gallbladder?
Skin, lungs, heart. So there's more, right?
Yeah.
So the brain, it beats the heart. We don't say heartbeat. Right now I'm warm. My brain is doing that, not me. The brain breathes, right? It's taking care of that. If there's a fever, the brain does look after the fever. We don't say, okay, body, we're going to have a fever. Don't really do that. The brain does that. And the brain has reactions, triggers, and habits. So just remember that as we move along here. So, got different colors here. So what if I said, and some of you already know this, but we're going to keep going along, that you aren't your brain. Okay? So I'm just going to put you, and I'm going to slash me, okay? We came in today bringing our brain, and we're carrying our body, okay? That's different. We're not our brain. And in my practice, this is a new thing for people. People think that they're their brains. They think that their reactions, their habits, that's them. It's not. It's your brain. So if we can step back for a minute and look at that. So I've got some ideas here. So, Terry, you mentioned the brain collects memory. What was it?
Was Kate.
Sorry, Kate. Okay. It came from that direction. What else? Since your brain was formed, so that's in vitro, since the brain was formed, what did it start doing?
Processing.
Processing? Someone else said, did I hear thinking?
Yeah.
Thinking.
Feeling.
Yeah.
Hearing.
Learning.
What's that? Learning, yes. So gathering information, right? So learning. So it's gathering information. Memories, history, okay? So this is a gathering of information. This is the brain's function. We don't say gather information. We don't do that. The brain's doing that. Okay, so, oh yeah, I want to write history here. Okay, patterns and senses, interpreting, yeah, put that in here, and please don't test me on spelling, so I'm just going to scribble it in there. The other thing that the brain collects, and actually we talked about this a little bit, is beliefs. And what's mentioned, I'm just trying to think about earlier, just even tonight. So the other thing the brain collects right away, is cultural beliefs and social beliefs. So what that means is culture is your heritage. Culture is your family. Okay, generations. So I'm going to put family up here. Give you a little story. A young mother, was cutting up a ham, and she chopped off the bone to the ham and put it in the pan. And her daughter, 6-year-old daughter, said, Mommy, why are you cutting off the bone? And she said, I don't know. Mom always did it. My mom always did it. Okay, she was curious. So the young mother went to her mother, and said, Mom, why do you cut off the bone for the ham? why do you do that? She goes, I don't know, but my mom always did it. So the great-grandmother was still alive, so when they went to visit her, they asked her. And they said, Granny, why are you cutting off the bone? Why do we do that? And she says, oh, darling, my stove was so small. As simple things, a true story, though generations do it without asking why. So we do this. We do this as a culture. We do it as Canadians. However, I'm German, so I'm coming from a culture of Germans. I had a colleague in Expressive Arts, and she was Spanish, so Mexican Spanish. And when we did our check-in, she would yell and scream and cry, and the rest of us, oh, we would cringe. But that was her culture. Culture is very comfortable doing that. I've been living with the Japanese student's been living with me, learning a whole different spectrum of culture about ourselves and about the Japanese culture. So that's cultures. Cultures will form beliefs. Okay, so that's what our brain is using, its beliefs. And social is where you've grown up. So did you grow up in a town? Did you grow up in a city? Did you go into a one schoolroom house or a big, big high school that had 3,000 people? Very different belief systems that you're going to collect. Okay, so these are just things that the brain is collecting. So now I just want to, I'm going to get a different color. What affects the brain? Tell me, what affects your brain?
Food.
Food, yes.
Sleep?
Yes.
Just
sleep and the lack of it, right? So either or, drugs. So I'm going to write chemicals, because this is chemistry, okay? So even water. What else?
Lack of water.
And lack of water. And you may know this already, so pardon me if you do. Lack of water can create symptoms of anxiety. Lack of water can create symptoms of anxiety. Another thing that I learned last year is low iron can create symptoms of depression. You will think that it's deep depression. Maybe get your iron checked. True.
Okay. External temperatures.
Temperatures.
Energy.
Yes, energy is a result. So I'm going to put that in another, well, no, I don't have to put another color, but yes.
Well, I was thinking like EMF and that kind of stuff.
Oh, okay. Yes. All right. Cool. And I'm going to write hormones, right? So, and the brain chemistry changes. There's also another one. And someone mentioned genes, like your hereditary genes. It's possible. Like you're going to, I think with what we're going to do today, you're going to see some things of where you can maybe change this. So what I'm proposing is that you become the CEO of your brain. Okay? So what that means is if you break your arm, you're going to help yourself out. Get a cast. If you have a cold, you're going to take care of it. So how do you do that, right? So you're becoming the CEO. You can be the CEO of your brain. We can change things. So I just want to keep going with that. I want you to think about that. Okay, so, oh, one more thing. And I knew there was something. Where is my, oh, here it is. Okay. Another thing that can happen is, and I'm going to call them small traumas, little T's and big T's. Because I'm not judging traumas, okay? Body processes trauma differently in every body. Science, as far along as we are in neuroscience, cannot even explain why the body will go, oh, we're not letting go of that trauma. But it may be what we might think is a bigger trauma. Somebody, you've processed it. But science cannot say why. So that makes it a mystery as to which trauma got processed or not. So what does the brain do? Okay, and the traumas, actually, I want to just finish. When there's been a lot of traumas, what we do know is the amygdala is ringing in your brain. Again, that's not you. You don't go amygdala, ring, ring, ring. You don't do that. And when your amygdala is activated, it's pouring cortisol on your brain. And if you have an amygdala that is very active and lots of cortisol, that affects your emotions, it affects your memory, it affects body and brain chemistry. There's new research, it's just starting to come out, that people that have, quote unquote, been diagnosed with depression or a deep depression, a bipolar, their body and brain chemistry has changed when they've healed. So it's possible. It's very interesting. So this is just now, just it's in the works. It's out there. So
with the release of all that cortisol too, it causes weight gain.
There you go. Weight gain. I didn't know that. Okay. So what does your brain do with all this? What happens? What happens? And we mentioned it. Remember I said remember those three words at the beginning? What happens? What does your brain do with this?
It compartmentalizes it.
Yeah. And what does it do? What happens? The brain has, think about this brain collecting the information. It's got all this information now. And its main function is to keep you alive. That's it. It's hardwired to keep you alive. So what is the brain going to do with all this information?
Store it.
Well, it does. However, it's going to protect you. So it will react. It's going to react. It will have triggers. And it creates habits. Okay? So this is the brain. A lot of people think, oh, I've got a bad habit. No, your brain got the bad habit. So, okay. I want to show you something else. This is interesting, and this has been a lot of fun with this talk because I have a lot of questions all the time. And trying to find out why, I've talked to a lot of people, and honestly, it's the human condition. We grab onto the negative before we go to the positive. I cannot answer that. I wish I knew. If you knew, I know Clinton doesn't know it. My other supervisors don't know. I've had other friends that are psychologists don't know. I don't know. So if you find the answer, email me, please. So.